In the electrical workshop, I like to confirm that our MFT testers are reading correctly for values of continuity, measured in ohms, and insulation resistance, measured in megohms, or megohms, if you like to say it that way, someone always corrects me. In order to do that, monthly, you should check your instrument out there on site for all of the tests that it can perform. However, this CalCard here allows my students to confirm the readings are correct for the continuity and insulation resistance test. In the workshop, we have a checkbox which allows us to check those live tests, etc. Or if you were going to confirm the live tests out there in industry, you could perhaps pick a designated socket at home to carry out an earth fault loop impedance test on it and an RCD test on it, so you're always repeating the same test on the same point. This card allows us for our students to confirm the instrument is working correctly. So we're going to confirm, first of all, brand new card out the packet. We're going to confirm, first of all, the readings from the card. And it's important that you record your readings on the back of the card. So if we were measuring our ohms reading, when we get our reading that should be 0.25, we record the actual reading the first time round. So that becomes your cross-reference for it. So let's see how we're going to do that. So we're going to first of all set our MFT tester, and it's our Megger 1711 we've got here, onto ohms. We're going to need to remove the resistance of the leads as we always do. So I'm going to use these two probes. I'm squeezing them together. And we've got zero. It isn't flashing, so we're going to go with that is zero. Remember, if it's flashing, it's gone below, and we need to press the test button and zero out. So we're at zero. And then what we do is we go between a common point, we've got one each side, and in this case, we're going to do the ohms of 0.25. Now, if everything's correct, we expect it to be 0.25, but whatever reading it is, that's the one we record on the back as our cross-reference point. So common connection, press nice and firmly, and onto 0.25, and actually we got 0.27. Okay, so we didn't get the ohms of 0.25, which we expected. So what you end up doing is turning it over and actually recording 0.27 ohms. So that becomes the reading then that you cross-reference in the future when you go between those two points. I'll continue on, but I'll fill the card out on my own at a later date. But let's see what we are getting as results and readings. So let's go for the next one. Common connection and 0.5. So we'd have to record 0.52. For our 1 ohm value of resistance, we got 1 ohm, so that would be recorded on the back as 1. Our 2 ohm resistor, again, it is 2 ohms, and our 5 ohm resistor is actually 4.96 ohms. So all of those results we just achieved there are recorded on the back, and they become the ones that we reference to in the future. Remember, we should be carrying this test out monthly. I like my students to do it every time before they actually use the MFT tester in the workshop. The next set is for insulation resistance. So the rest of the readings here are in megohms. Okay, so we're going to do exactly the same process again. We'll pick up a common, and we should get 0.5, 1, 2, 10, and 20 megohms to confirm the instrument is reading correctly. In order to do that, we're going to come into the megohm scale here, and we can only go for this card as high as, I think, 500 volts. And that's the one we're going to use in the workshop anyhow, so that's the one we're going to calibrate against. So this time, we come in, we're going to go between common and, in this case, 0.5 of a megohm, or megohm, however you want to say it. Press and hold the test button, and we got exactly 0.5. We move it across to the 1 megohm. So this time we actually got 0.98. So let's record that one on the back. So when we test between there, we actually got 0.98 megohms. Just put it down as an M, like they did. So that shows us it's slightly different. I'll just go through the rest of them and not record them, just to see what they are. So if we go between these two points, the common and 2, press and hold my tester. A fraction less than that, so we record that reading of 1.98. Come across to my 10 megohm, and we get a reading of, ooh, considerably less. So you can see how important it is to get it correct. So that's 9.47. And then finally, we test between it from the 20, and we get 19.4. Okay. And all those results are recorded onto the back here, and we keep that with us. And then that will follow the test instrument around, because we'll have the actual readings. It's important that we validate, in this case, our dead results using this CalCard. In the industry, you could use a socket outlet for live tests if you want to test the RCD loop test and that, but we don't, so just confirm that. So this card here allows us to work out our continuity, for our continuity CPC test that we carry out, as well as our insulation resistance test by using this as our cross-reference. Handy little card to have, I would suggest all my apprentices should get one of these before the end of their course. But as always, I hope this video has been some help.